going back where I killed that doe yesterday and jumped that good buck. Only got a little bit of a look at him on video, and of course I saw him in person, kind of, but looks like he might be a shooter. If not, there could be another good one in here too. Alright, there's not much cover here. If you get into cover, then you can't see. Keeps doing that, I'm gonna shoot him. I think he's a little younger than I thought. He's real nice. He was very tempting. I mean, he stopped. Obviously, I could have shot him. I had my hammer cocked and everything, but he wasn't He wasn't the one I wanted to burn my last tag on. But I was very close to shooting him. He's a pretty deer. Look at this fresh bed right here. It's mine. It's where I was sitting all morning. Spot that might be better for the wind in terms of bedding. I had a perfect wind this morning, but not a whole lot of bedding upwind of where I was. Got a couple hours of daylight left. I'm going to go in and sit at the back of this slough here, and maybe we'll catch something slipping through. It's a good little pinch point.
Thank you.
That smaller buck is trying hard to get after that doe. The bigger one wouldn't let him have it. The little one's right here, trying to get behind him, but the bigger one went off with his doe into CRP. Well, on that note, I think I'm gonna head back to the canoe and call it a day. Once the hot does become fewer and farther between, probably start seeing more mature buck activity, or at least hopefully. I'd like to at least lay eyes on one. I know they're out here. I don't know where I'm gonna hunt yet tomorrow, but I do have the whole rest of the week off, and I will be hunting hard, so I'll see you all again very soon.